This is set up for the Google Nest battery-powered doorbell, and I'm basing it pretty much off of this card, which is the instructions for this. So step one, we're gonna plug in our doorbell using the cable. You then download the Google Home app and then scan the QR code right here. Same QR code exists on the back of the device. So if you lose this, don't worry about it. So for us, step one, we're gonna go plug this in, and then we already have the app and we'll move on from there. All right, so we have our cable plugged into a power supply, and I'm gonna plug it into the back of the camera. Little white light came on right there. Audio cue from the Nest doorbell. Color of that LED has changed from white to blue. Gonna give that another second to see if it changes again. If not, we do have the Google Home app open and ready and waiting. All right, so now it's just kind of pulsing. So we're gonna take that as the cue to bring in the Google Home app right here. And we are going to do just like it said, which is up here in the upper left-hand corner, we select the plus sign, and then we say add or set up a new device. So we're gonna select that. So we have two choices. We have new device, which this is, or works with Google. So we're gonna select new device, and then off camera, it's showing my two different home locations. So I am going to select my primary home location, and then it wants us to allow nearby devices. So we're gonna say next and allow location access, select next, and it's looking for devices, which is slightly different than the basic instructions. So let's see what we're looking for here. Doorbell, Nest doorbell battery, that's what we have. Now we're getting to the point where we're scanning the QR code. So we're gonna do that very quickly off camera. So I have that scanned. We're gonna hit next, have to agree, terms of service, next. No, I'm not helping you with data. That's up to you if you wanna do that or not. Plug in the doorbell, which I already have. So the instructions that it came with and the instructions you get from the app are slightly different, but our doorbell is already connected to power, so we're gonna let that do its thing. All right, so it's asking us to press the button to wake it up. So I have pressed it, nothing's changed over here, but we're gonna hit next and see what that does. All right, I'll be interested to see what network this actually places the doorbell on, considering that I have an IoT specific network, but that's not necessarily what my phone is currently on or what my other Google Home product is linked to. So we'll see which one it picks up on. All right, now it's looking for Wi-Fi networks, connecting to Wi-Fi network, hasn't actually, connecting, finishing up. It didn't let me know which one it connected to, so I'll have to look at that in the settings area later. Doorbell beeped or chimed, it says all set. Where is this device? Well, considering it's a doorbell, I don't think it's in any of these rooms. We're gonna say front door and next. As with anything, there is a firmware update that needs to be downloaded depending on when you purchase. All right, got another beep because it's making progress. All right, so it's asking how we'll be powering this. I'm gonna say battery because I'm not plugging it into the wired terminal. And now it's actually kind of walking you through what you'll need for installation, a power drill and a Phillips head screwdriver. You have a choice to watch the video, or you can say it's already installed or select next, which will walk you through kind of all the steps. So we're gonna say next, camera on, it's letting you know the green light, live view, it'll pulse it. And here we have our video history. So that's gonna be your saving of cloud clips and recordings, letting you know depending on where you are, it may or may not be legal to do, so you have an option to toggle that on or off. I'm gonna leave that on. All right, so right here we can turn our microphone on or off, or we can select audio recording. It's letting you know when audio recording is off, if the microphone is left on, it will still let you hear what's going on, but it won't record those to the clips. Again, some local laws allow you to video but not have audio. This is actually gonna be something you're probably gonna wanna set up later. I'm sure they'll let you get to it, but it's visitor announcement, and depending on if you have friendly faces type AI turned on, it will let you have a unique announcement for each of them. I'm gonna leave that off for now, and hopefully I'll be able to get back to that. What is your spoken language? English, US for me. And then here we have try Nestaware at no charge. Get 60-day trial with 30 days of event video history. And what you get with this is see what you missed, know who, so that's familiar faces, hear alarms while you're away, so stuff for smoke detector, quick call 911 emergency. I'm going to select not, and then this is just them trying to push product information to you. So we're gonna say no thanks. And then another video saying how to get the most out of your device. We're gonna select next, and then getting your device ready. I will say this is one of the longer doorbell setups that I've actually had. considering that I thought it would be reasonably quick based on the information that came with it. And we're gonna select done. And now it has been added to all of my devices. But that has been the setup for the Google Nest battery doorbell.